age of the Heroku free tier is now gone, and now we're left with figuring out where to deploy our applications without incurring huge costs. And for someone like me, that's a major hobbyist and loves deploying different applications all the time, where do I go now? Well, there is a solution. Why not run your own Heroku-like service yourself and deploy all your applications to that? Let's check out Dokku and see how easy it is to set it up and start running your applications. But Dokku is built as an open source platform as a service alternative to Heroku. And once you get started using Dokku, you'll see that's exactly what it is. You can use Git to deploy to Dokku just like you would with Heroku, and you can easily configure services to run in Dokku just like you would with Heroku. So instead of paying for a separate Postgres database or Redis, you can easily spin up those dependencies and get those running for your application. And it's super easy to deploy and set up. Let's check out how to do that. When you visit the docs, they have a high level overview of how to set up everything, the dependencies you'll need in your server. But the easiest way to get started is either using the Azure installation or DigitalOcean Droplet, because they come with all the configurations you need to easily deploy your application. Let's use the Azure installation flow. The first thing you'll need is to generate an SSH key pair. So let's do that right now. We'll go to generate a new SSH key. Choose your platform, whether it's Mac, Windows, or Linux. I'm on a Mac, so let's go through the Mac instructions. Right now, when deploying with Azure, you'll need to use the older legacy SSH key generation. So let's copy that and head over to the terminal window. Let's copy and paste the SSH key gen and put in your email address that you will be using. Click Enter and start generating your SSH key. By default, it's going to call your SSH key ID underscore RSA, but I highly recommend giving it a new name because likely you already have an existing RSA key, and also it makes it easier to manage to know which keys you're using for which service. I'm going to go ahead and call this Dokku Demo. Let's create it. Alrighty. So we have our SSH key created. Now let's go on to the next step. Now we're going to go to the deployment page for Azure. This will take us over to a GitHub repo that has the deployment configurations to deploy to Azure with basically almost one-click deployment. So deploy to Azure. For obvious reasons, you'll need an Azure account. Make sure to set that up. Make sure to set up a subscription where your billing is set up so you can go through this process. Once you have that all set up, you'll be taken to a page that already has all the configurations for all the dependencies for your Dokku services. It's going to create 6 resources, and luckily we don't have to worry about much of the configuration. Choose your subscription first. Most likely you're only going to have 1 subscription, and then I highly recommend creating a new resource group. So I'm going to create a Dokku demo resource group. And this is highly recommended because it makes it really easy to delete your services if you're no longer going to use them. You don't need to go running around figuring out what services were created and what services you need to delete. If you go through this tutorial and then you decide that you do not want to use Dokku, all you need to do is go to that resource group, Dokku Demo, or whatever you call it, and just delete the entire resource group, and it'll delete all of the dependencies inside that resource group, making it really easy just to wipe out everything you did and not have to worry about reoccurring billing happening. Select your region, wherever you want it to be hosted, and then choose your username. Give this a random username. And then SSH key. So this goes to where the step that we used before. So choose existing public key. And what we'll need to do is we'll need to copy and paste our SSH key in. So let's go ahead and print out our SSH key. I'm going to use the cat command. Paste that in. Make sure there's no extra white spaces at the end. That can be a big gotcha. And then give it a DNS label prefix, basically your domain name that you want to do. So I'm going to call this Goose Dokku Demo. And with that, all I got to do is create and review. And then it'll validate all our settings are looking good. And now we just click create. Great. And now we just got to wait. So in this step, it'll set up all the necessary dependencies to get Dokku up and running, the server, the network gates, a lot of stuff that you don't actually have to worry about because everything's going to be set up properly for you. And through the magic of YouTube, we'll go ahead and skip to the next step and don't have to wait for all this stuff. All right, so now it is done. I would recommend going for a walk around the block or, you know, going for a nice coffee break because it's going to take a little while before this is finished. But when it's done, you should see this page update with saying your deployment is complete. The next step is you can just go ahead to the resource group. And I will go to the Dokku VM. So now we have our Dokku VM up and running with all the configurations. And here is our DNS. If we copy that to the clipboard and try hopping on over and navigating to that, we can see that we have a generic welcome page because Dokku is running and it's just running in Nginx to route our traffic. Great. All right, so now let's try setting up our deployment. What we'll need to do is we'll need to SSH into our server so we can start setting things up to do our deployment. Let's go ahead and copy our URL and head over to the terminal. We're going to do SSH-I. We're going to be selecting the custom key that we generated. So SSH/Dokku_demo. And then the user, so demo goose was our user. And then it's going to be the URL to our server. And then we want to put in your passcode for what you set it for the SSH key. All right, now we're in the server. Now what we need to do is we need to set up the SSH key for deployments. Let's copy and paste this so we can add in the SSH key as an admin for doing deployments. So let's paste that in. And we'll have to do one small tweak to this because this command has to be set up as a root user. So we're gonna prepend sudo in front of the Dokku command. And that is done. Great. The next step is to set up your domain. If you have a custom domain, you would do the first step, but given that we do not have a custom domain and we are using the default domain from Azure, we're going to go ahead and do the IP address. So let's do set global, and then we'll go and grab the IP address. Paste that in. Save, set. Great. Now we have our application set up. Now we can actually do a deployment. Let's go to deploy an application. Deploying an application is going to be pretty much the exact same experience that you're going to have with Heroku. Dokku uses a couple of different ways to handle deployments. The most familiar is they're going to be using an application called Heroku-ish. Heroku-ish emulates the way Heroku manages deployments using build packs. If you're already familiar with deploying your Node, Ruby, Python application using and configuring build packs, exact same thing. You can use the same build packs that you use for Heroku, you can use for Dokku. If you're previously using the free tier on Heroku, you can just easily take those and deploy them to Dokku without much change whatsoever. And because it uses Heroku-ish, major languages are already supported and already detected for doing deployments. So Ruby, Node, Java, all of these applications are automatically detected when deploying and it'll automatically select those build packs for you. That's really cool. Instead of going through this tutorial, I thought we'd change things up and let's try deploying a Node application instead. Here I pulled up a Node.js getting started application from Heroku. It's just a bare bones Node.js application that uses Express to run a server. There is nothing special in here. There's not even a build pack. All there is a proc file to tell Heroku or Dokku how to run the application. We're going to go ahead and try using this application. So let's clone it. Let's exit out of the server and let's do the git clone. And I'm using the GitHub CLI to clone it, but use whatever means you want. Let's go into Node.js getting started. And now we are in our getting started. Let's just go ahead and run npm i. And let's make sure that this application actually runs. npm start listening on port 5001. And there we go. We have our example app up and running, which is great. Just a simple splash page. All right, let's go ahead and try to deploy this guy. There's two ways you can configure your application to run. Either we can go directly and set up the application on the machine, but an easier way is to install the Dokku CLI locally. And I did that using brute install Dokku. And this simplifies the process and makes it feel more like Heroku. So you don't have to SSH into the machine in order to start creating the apps. Instead, you can use the CLI to remotely configure your application. So once you have Dokku installed, you're going to reach the first hiccup where if you try to call Dokku, it's going to complain and it's not going to know who you're communicating with. So it either suggests you add a git remote host, or what you can do is you can set your Dokku host environment variable so it knows where to communicate to. What that would look like, at least in line, is if we do Dokku host and we copy paste the DNS to our server. And now we are successfully communicating with our Dokku service. If we were to do Dokku apps list, we would not have any apps running on our service right now. So that is the next step. Let's create our app. Dokku create, and we're going to call this our goose node, because why not? And we got to remember to always prefix our Dokku host for now, unless you go into your bash RC or Z shell RC and set up the environment variable to always run. But for now, for demo purposes, let's just do this. So create goose node. Great. So our application has been created. The interesting thing is that now that since we created the application using the CLI tool, the remote has already been added in. So now we could see that along with the origin, we also have a Dokku remote. So just like with Heroku, where you would have a Heroku remote that we push to, now we have a Dokku remote that we can push to. If you follow along with the original guy with Ruby on Rails, it also goes through the motions of installing the Postgres plugin and creating a database for you, so for your application to use, all hosted within Dokku. But our node application doesn't really need any of that, so we're going to skip that part. And in the guide, it would have gone through setting up that remote, but since we use the CLI locally to communicate with the remote server, it already went through that and did that for us. So now we just need to do the last part here, is actually push to Dokku. So git push Dokku main. And we don't need to do this step here because on the server, main already exists. And it's not alias to master. So we should be able to do git push Dokku main. And just like with Heroku, if we do a push, it's going to push it up to Dokku. And then Dokku is going to recognize that we are doing a deployment and start the build process. So we can already see here that it is using Heroku-ish to identify our application. And it's going to notice that we are deploying a node application. So it's going to automatically apply the node build pack and start to do all the steps necessary to do a deployment, like doing the npm install and having node in there so it can actually run. And now we just sit back and wait for this deployment to finish. All right, so the deployment is finished and our application has been deployed to this location here for our IP address and the port. So let's try that out, and boom, we have our application up and running at that IP address. Great. It was just that easy to get it deployed because we're using already the existing Heroku-like magic, but all self-hosted using our own service. So the domain name is a little ugly. It's this IP address plus your port. But if you have your own custom domain, there is a step that you can use for setting up your SSL using Let's Encrypt, so you can have auto renewing SSL cert for free and start pushing to your own domain really, really easily. I've done this in the past. That's it. That's a simple walkthrough for setting up Dokku and deploying your very first application, there is a lot of different stuff that I haven't even touched. Just like with Heroku, you can deploy multiple applications. You can set up subdomains in your application. So you can have a Node server, Ruby on Rails, Elixir, Go, all these different applications running on a single server. You can configure it to run Redis, Postgres, a bunch of different services. You can do no downtime deployments. You can do serverless also using the same interface that Lambda uses. I haven't even gotten into everything. I've only used it for just deploying simple applications and getting them hosted just to play around with. Oh yeah, one last tip before I forget. If you just want the tutorial just to set up Dokku, but don't intend to use it right now, let's make sure to clean up all the services so you don't forget and end up getting billed at the end of the month. Going back to Azure and we're in our Dokku VM, you can go to the resource group. So we created that resource group. I called it Dokku Demo. If you click on that, we see all the different services that were created under that resource group. And these are all the ones that the wizard went through and created all six of these. And if we want to delete all of the Dokku setup and avoiding any billing, all we got to do is delete the resource group. So just click apply and you type in the name of your resource group. Click delete and you're done. That's it. That's how easy it is on Azure to clean up after yourself. So if you end up using more Azure for experimenting with different things, make sure to just throw it into a resource group. And once you're done, delete the resource group and you don't have to worry about missing anything for billing at the end of the month. Hopefully you found this guide informative. If there's anything I missed that needs to be called out, let me know and I can address them and put them in the comments. Check out the comments for all the links. And if you like what you see, please consider hitting that subscribe button. Greatly appreciate it. And I'll catch you in the next one.